and through the rivers they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, they shall not burn thee, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. God is saying that he's going to be there for you. Now, literally what it's saying here, through all these writers, it's saying that your trials are set up for God's glory. That if you didn't have the trial, that God wouldn't have the chance to show up strong for you. That everything is a setup. Literally, Jesus said the same thing in St. John 11, around the time of Lazarus' demise. He said that this sickness is not unto death, but for the Son of God to be glorified thereby. That there are literally times, situations, and instances where your problems are a chance for God to show up strong. That God dresses up and God goes on and puts on his Sunday best to show himself strong in your situation. That when everybody thought that you were about to wave the white flag, or everybody had just, the fat lady had just about got ready to sing, that God is saying that he'll show up, and our God is a deliverer that sometimes comes in at the ninth hour, the tenth hour, the 11th hour, even the extra hour. God can come and save and deliver you even when time is run out. Lazarus was dead for 4 days, and there was the teaching of the people of that day that if your body we literally circled around your soul, circled around your body for 3 days, and to enter your body. Again, it was the teaching of that day. But it was at the advent of the fourth day that you were all the way dead, that it was for sure that you were dead and gone. So Lazarus was dead 4 days. He was all the way gone, and God still comes up and says, I am the resurrection and the life. And literally God is saying that in some of your situations, that you think that some of your situations are over, that you think that some of your situations aren't worthy of worrying over, that you think that your situations are dead and gone, but God is still saying that I am the resurrection and the life. I can bring you back from the dead. I can bring your dreams back from the dead. I can breathe new hope into your dreams. I can breathe a new strength into your body. Literally, I'm still telling you that your weakness has landed you in God's territory. I heard Jensen Franklin say one time that miracles happen in miracle territory. That so many times we want to see the miraculous, but we don't want the situations that call for miracles. Literally, wherever there was a miracle in the Bible, there was a need. There was an adversity, there was a problem, there was a circumstance, and miracles show up in miracle territory. That miracles don't show up for the pretty, that miracles don't show up for the proper and prim, that miracles show up as sometimes in the worst situations of their life. And I'm telling you right now, literally like I said, I found my place right there. I got my aha moment right there, that literally your weakness is landing you in God's territory. When we said miracles move in miracle territory, that God moves sometimes in God's territory. That some of the worst places of your life, that his strength is made perfect in your weakness. That God said that he's going to show himself strong in all of the weak places of your life. And literally, I was writing, he said, God told me that we need to stop running from challenges. That challenging situation that you're going through, whether it be in your finances, whether it be in your body, whether it be in your home, that's God's best place to operate for you. That's God's territory. You need to go to your job. If you're having problems on your job, and then when walk around before everybody gets to work and say, this is all God's territory, that's the place for God to work, that your challenging situations, your challenging circumstances are right where God can show himself strong. God's still talking to me. He says, Steve, leave me room to work. We don't need God enough room to work. We're not leaving God margin to work. We're not leaving capacity for God to work. That you can't do it on your own. That if you do it on your own, it'll turn into a horrible mess. We need to literally leave God room to work. He still said to me, he said, Steve, my grace is sufficient in the midst of your weakness. That literally he said that my strength is made perfect in weakness. And as I close, I'll just paraphrase from the Message Bible on this particular scripture. He said, because of the extravagance of those revelations, and so I wouldn't get a big head. That some of the stuff you're going through is keeping you from getting a big head. And the big head would put you in a place of pride. The big head would put you in a place of devastation. It would get you out of the place of humility, which will exalt you. He said, in the Message Bible, I was given the gift of a handicap to keep me in constant touch with my limitations. That your human limitations, your human handicaps, whether that be a proclivity, whether that be inclination, whether that be a sickness in your body, that wherever you're weak, that God can show himself strong. That God doesn't want you to get so puffed up in pride that you go over the edge because of all of that you are. That God wants to leave you room that you need to still look up to him. And that it's in you that we live, move, and have our being. That you still need to know that your next breath only comes from the grace of God. That God conquered death, hell, and the grave for you. And literally, I'm telling you right now that your weakness has landed you in God's territory. I'm thankful on this morning that God has put me in a place that my weaknesses, as many as they are, has put me in a place of God's territory. That folks can look at me and say, how in the world is God using him? And God can come and show himself strong. And God shows up on my behalf and says, this is all about me, and it's not about Steve. Still reading from the Message Bible. He said, Satan's angel did his best to get me down. And many times, the devil starts on the early hour and goes to late at night besieging you. Sometimes it seems like the devil has your name, address, and telephone number at home and at work. And literally, he said, Satan's angel did his best to keep me down. What he in fact did was push me to my knees. Sometimes the devil hits you so hard that he gets you in the most strategic place that you need to be. The devil hit you so hard it made you fall on your knees. That literally that's the place that your weakness has left you in God's territory. I praise God for the time that the devil has beat me up so bad that he landed me on my knees. Many of us didn't meet God on the mountaintop. Most of us have met God in the valleys, tough and rough places of our lives. Still reading from the Message Bible. He says, same thing with the excess of getting down, and he did, in fact, was to push me in my knees. No change then of walking around high and mighty, that you're not all of that, that everything that you are is because of the character, the grace of God. And at first, I didn't think of it as a gift, and I begged God to remove it. Three times I did that, and then he told me, my grace is enough. It's all you need. My strength comes into its own in your weakness. That my strength has more power.